Well, Liverpool, they used to call it the capital of Ireland. That's one thing. So you'd always be around a lot of music. It's a very musical city. There are certain few. Glasgow, I think, is another. They liked the music there, you know. So you had all the kind of old music hall stuff, which was going through my dad's era. You know, my dad used to work on a spotlight in the music halls. And so he got a lot of influence from all of that, you know, all the old music hall acts, which he passed on to me just by playing piano. He used to work on the limelights when it was actually a piece of lime that they burned. And he had to trim the piece of lime. And he used to come home after the first house on the music hall, and he'd bring home programs from the first house, and my Auntie Millie would iron them. And he'd take them back for second house and flog them again.
A taste of honey, tasting much sweeter than wine. Do-do-do-do.
Say a lot of the sailors brought, I mean, in Liverpool you'd know about people like Big Bill Brunsey, Gene Vincent, Bill Haley, Ray Charles, Chuck Berry, Little Richard, Elvis, before a lot of people in America knew about it, really. It was the big kind of blues country. There's a huge kind of country following in Liverpool, for instance. Again, I suppose off the travellers, you know, mainly the sailors, a lot of sailors shipped out of Liverpool. You've got the Irish influence, the old Irish folk music was very like an Indian music, you know, it's a very rich thing to draw on, all of that. So put it all together and you kind of find all of my influences in there, you know, from kind of Fred Astaire to Big Bill Brunsey, you know, it's quite a way.